Hello everybody, it's Sunday, it's FRR Racing, it's Project Cars, and it's something a little bit different here today compared to what we would usually do on Project Cars on a Sunday night. With the FRR Racing Season 5 DTM having finished a couple of weeks ago, we decided that we needed to test out a couple of things on Project Cars and also... just give the drivers the chance of doing something a little bit mental. So I'm from a racing DP, and joining me in the not so professional commentary box this week is from a racing JS. How are you, James?
I'm always professional.
Okay, we're on a relaxed night, so I'll let you have that one. I'll just point out though to the viewers, whether we have any or not, it doesn't really matter, but obviously we always enjoy having viewers on their live streams. The things that we want to test today is there's a couple of things with the way the format of the season 5 was, with having a random grid. We wanted to try and find a way that we can improve the way the random grid works. So we are going to be testing one of those things today, and that being what we're thinking of doing is we'll send the drivers to the track for a 5-minute warm-up session, and then there'll be a qualifying session, but we'll skip that qualifying session and we'll see what the game does and see if it does what we want it to. The drivers will then be allowed to go and have a race. The second race at that track, though, is going to be a rallycross event. What's the rallycross event? It's as simple as this. There are no rules. You can go wherever you want. You can do whatever you want. You can crash into whoever you want. You can cut corners as much as you like. It's a case of first to the finish. So it's just a bit of fun, and we may see some interesting crashes. Now, we may not have many drivers in the lobby at the moment, but we're not too fussed about that because, like I say, it's a bit of a test session. But if you are watching this and you do want to come and have a bit of fun, just send FrontRowRacing_JS a message on PlayStation or on the FrontRow Racing community and ask for an invite, and we'll get you in for the next one. So how long we'll be on for, not entirely sure, but also it's a good opportunity for any of the drivers that have been showing interest in getting involved in FrontRow Racing on Project Cars to just come along, have a bit of a race, but then also have a bit of a mental race. Maybe even the possibility of some of those drivers who have been crashed into a few times this season, the opportunity to get some legal revenge.
Right, so we are testing out the issue that we had last season, where in the sprint race, because we did a random grid, the issue we had was both admins ended up on the front row. We're trying to work out how to get around this issue so that we end up being at the back. So
yes,
bear with us.
Yeah, I mean, there was something else that we might try a little bit later, something I haven't actually mentioned to you yet, James, which was whether, if there was a rolling start, whether we would be able to sort of retire from the session before the race gets going.
Yeah, now I have already tested that scenario. And unfortunately, it doesn't allow you to retire until you go over the start-finish line. Now, it does give you control of your car before you end up going over the start-finish line. So you're still... you're not in as much of a position to ruin anybody's race. However, we know what people are like as soon as they get control of the car. You might want to move one way and they might want to move another.
Yeah, that is quite possible. That is why we would want to test out those kind of things. But anyway, so if you are watching this and you're thinking, you know what, I might want to just come and have a bit of fun on the track, then drop from a racing JS a message on PSN, and we'll see if we can get you in. Like I say, for us, it is just a bit of a test session, just to test out some lobby settings while allowing a couple of new guys the opportunity to get a bit of track time, and also to give the viewers some Sunday night TV viewing. So what have we got for them, James?
We've got the Renault Club Sport, and yeah, it's it looks a lot better than it sounds, unfortunately. It's the first time I've properly heard this car when not being in the cockpit, and it sounds a bit like as if you've got somebody either a bee or a mouse trying to fart.
Yeah, both of which are not particularly good things. But yeah, I mean, these are, they're mental little cars though, really, aren't they? I mean, they've got some power, they've got some speed to them, and on this track they could be quite interesting. Now, regarding FRR Racing's Project Cars Season 6, I'm just wondering whether you'd be able to give the viewers some information. Obviously, we're going to be putting information out on Facebook, but I'm wondering if there's anything that you can let the viewers know now, and potentially some of the drivers.
Well, we have crowned Michelin Man as the FRR Racing Project Cars champion for Season 5. And, yeah, it was a very, very close battle with him and Kaesler throughout that season. But then, about three, four races from the end, we saw glimpses of absolute genius from Gingerbread Man, who was close friends with Michelin Man, so if I'm not getting too mixed up with the
man,
yeah. But yeah, they're absolutely a brilliant set of drivers, and yeah, Gingerbread Man showed utter raw pace that even Kaesler, who's a veteran of Project Cars now, couldn't live with in some scenarios.
Yeah.
So yeah, we've got them. We have got Michelin Man and Gingerbread Man, who I believe will be fighting it out tooth and nail for the title. Now, I'm not 100% confirmed on this, but I believe Kaesler has hung his gloves up for next season, as he is starting a new job, and he's told me it's going to take up a lot of his time. So. Luckily for the viewers, though, they've got a full-on battle between two friends, and we know what it gets like in Formula 1 when friends end up being on the same piece of tarmac.
Friendship,
they don't know each other.
Friendship only lasts until the door of the car closes. But, I mean, information about the cars for next season, it's going to be the DTMs again, yes?
Yeah, it's going to still be the DTM class cars, as a few of the drivers didn't have the Game of the Year edition and paid for the DLC for that particular car that we wanted to use. So I thought may as well get his money's worth and use it again for this coming season.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, this warm-up session is over for the drivers. Now, this is where we're going to test something out. So there'll be a qualifying session, but James is actually going to skip the qualifying session, and that'll take us through to the race. And if our theory is correct, it should put myself and James, because we see the drivers there. Oh,
hopefully,
James, where's the qualifying session?
I skipped it.
Oh, right, okay. I'm still at the front then. That's not good. Okay, we may have to do another test on that one. I must admit, I didn't see you skip it, but there we go. So, race, these guys, they're going to have a bit of a race then as Kula Kutu heads down into the lead at turn one. But yeah, this race is more of a sort of realistic race. Keep it nice and clean if you can. Race properly is what I would say. However, the next race we have around this track in after seven laps is going to be potentially something a little different. I was going to say, James, as well, at the end of this race, you may just want to, whichever drivers we have in the lobby, you may just want to sort of pop a group message together. It might be something you could... Oh, we've got two spinners, Dave the Harp! He's seen
the
car...
Oh, Dave the Harp already retired. Is he returned to circuit?
No, he returned to circuit. I think Dave the Harp saw Yuzi over there and thought, you know what, you're new. I don't want you to feel lonely. I'll come and join you over there. But yeah, yeah, so... I was going to say, for these seven laps, these guys can out race and sort of see what they've got. Show us what they've got. The next race, though, the no holds barred. You can go wherever you want. You can do whatever you want, and that's why it's called Rallycross. If you do want to get involved as well, as I've already mentioned, drop from a racing JS a message on PlayStation asking for an invite, or even on the PSN from a racing Project Cars community, or you can mention it on the YouTube chat. and I can tell James to drop you an invite. But yeah, going back on to next season, season 6 it'll be on Project Cars. We'll be using the DTMs again. Information is going to be going out on Facebook in the next couple of days regarding next season, so definitely worth keeping an eye out. But also, there was a post put out on the community and also on Facebook a couple of days ago, and even though it was on the 1st of April, it wasn't an April Fool's joke. Oh, we've got a spin out break, and Glaze, he's spun it at the chicane. He's going to try and get going again as Dave the Harp now closes in on the back of him, and Dre recovers from a little off himself. I think Breaker Clays may have got a bit of a power boost penalty there as well. But yeah, yeah, I was going to say, there was a post put out on Facebook because James is looking for four potential admins for the Project Cars side of Front Row Racing. Oh, Dave the Harp is going to try and make an overtake here.
Yeah, he's got his full beam on, and he's going full whack. Let's see if he can go around the outside at turn one.
No, he can't.
I don't think you were expecting that.
Oh, well, I think Dave knows that his brake pedal works. Either that or these Renaults, you make a little bit of contact and they stop dead.
I don't think that was his brake pedal. I think that was his handbrake.
Well, I just hope he didn't smack his head against the windscreen. Kalukutu, though, he'll be absolutely buzzing. I'm hoping. Did you just make a fart noise or was that you having a drink?
No. That was me having a drink, and I swear to God, it was me having a drink.
I feel sorry for your missus glass. If every time you go out to the pub for a drink, you're there like... every
the glass just touched the edge of the microphone, and that is the sound it made.
Oh, right, so that was glass touching microphone. Okay, I'll let you off then. okay. So yeah, as I was mentioning there, James is looking for four potential admins for the Project Cars side of Front Row Racing, information was put on Facebook about that. So if you're potentially interested in getting involved in the admin side of things, check out the post. It was put on the Facebook page on Saturday with some information on there. So yeah, feel free to check that out. I mean, anyone can apply to it, but there are obviously specifications to it.
We did see from Temp Fear, he'd messaged saying, why are we asking for four admins?
When you can have me?
Yeah, exactly. And he didn't seem to reply to me next one saying, are you having a laugh? But yeah, no, he didn't seem to reply. But the reason we wanted to have four was just for the plain reason of we know, in us out of hearts, me and you and Steve, how much it takes out of you to run these things. Now, if you've got four people, it takes pressure off, especially if, for example, on a certain day you can't make it. You've got three other people there that can back you up.
Yeah.
Whereas if it's all down to one person, if somebody makes a mistake, like, somebody's just made a mistake down at turn one, as Dave's gone up the inside of braking clays, that's a nice little move, but braking clays coming back. Yep, the reason for having four is just to take the pressure off, but still have an absolutely... brilliant season if we've got a brilliant overtake going on by Dave, but braking place turning in and two cars wanting to mate there, it looked like.
Yep. Well, I mean, obviously, with these cars as well, I mean, we didn't warn the drivers which cars they're going to be in. They've got no setups on the cars or anything like that. It's sort of pick up and play. So there's going to be some interesting moments. And these cars, I mean, Kulakutu, he's doing well out there. I mean, I've tried driving these cars. It was a while ago. But, yeah, they can be a little bit of a handful. As for what cars we're going to use for the Rallycross race, I can't say that even I know. Which is a common theme of the Project Cars series. There's a lot of stuff that I don't know, even though people think that I do. But anyway, we'll move on from that, shall we?
people think we're magicians and we're tampering like the Emperor in Star Wars.
I saw a brilliant picture the other day of a guy sitting on a sitting at a gym working on some weights, and he looked just like the Emperor from Star Wars, and someone actually tagged it as working out to be the Emperor. It was a brilliant picture. Oh, Ettel, he's coming under a bit of pressure from Yuzi. Can Yuzi get him? Interestingly, with these cars though, James, when you mentioned, I mean, these cars are good fun to drive. Yuzi chucks it over the inside, but I think Breaker Glaze has done what Ettel has just done here, or Yuzi has just done there, my apologies. In the DTMs, this 7-lap race would have been over by now, wouldn't it?
Yeah, definitely. When I put 7 laps on, I thought, ooh, yeah, 5, 6, 7 minutes at max, and now I'm thinking, yeah, 2 minutes per lap, it's quarter of an hour.
Yeah, I think for the rallycross race, you might want to knock it down to, say, 3 laps, because it could be absolute carnage. And I'll reiterate, for anyone that doesn't know what a rallycross event is, basically, you can drive wherever you want. If you want to cut a corner, you cut a corner. If you want to cut a corner by 100 yards, go for it. It's all allowed, Azetto. You can't cut that bit. There's a barrier there.
Yeah, I think he really did just hear you. Thought, right, I'll cut it.
I'll go over this bit. Yeah, it doesn't work over there.
I think he thought he were in a tank from GoldenEye.
Yeah, I tell you, do you know how old that film is?
1995.
Yeah. That is 22 years old.
I was 5 years old.
I was old enough to be old enough to watch it. Oh dear. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what, we've got an interesting little race going on here. But I do still want to keep touching on next season as well. Right with what you were saying about the admins. I mean, something that we were looking at as well is, we've talked about it a little bit over the course of season 5. K-Slay has been hosting the sort of community events on the Friday evenings, and as far as I'm aware, they're still happening. So
he's still running them.
Yeah, so for people that do want to get involved in the Project Car side of FRR Racing, Friday nights, come and join K-Slay for a few races. And I'll tell you what, if you show your worth in there, when reserve events become available, was that Dave the Art not tying at his brakes?
Yeah.
Dave, you got to save that stuff for the next race. If reserve places come available in the DTMs, then that's where you can get your name sort of. You'll have K-Slay and James here and other drivers saying, you know what, you need to give this guy an opportunity, because the Sunday events, basically there's going to be 14 drivers and it's them for the season. Some of them may fall out, some of them may have, like as you said with K-Slay, may get new jobs, may not be able to race, reserve positions may become available. All these two, they're really going at it here, aren't they? Sorry, I could have cut you off again there. It's Friday night. So, yeah, come and join K-Slay. Oh, it's going on. There's another one. Yeah, they're meant to be saving this for the next race. But Breaking Clays, he may gain here. He may benefit from this little battle, or he could just make it 10 times worse. We'll wait and see. So Friday nights, from about, I think it's 8 p.m. Excuse me, UK time. Come and join K-Slay on Project Cars for a few races. Season 6, though, may well be getting underway next weekend. But information, as I said, that'll be posted to the FRR Racing Facebook page. It's always the best place to check for full details. These two are still going at it. Brilliant stuff. It's Woolhouse and Dave the Arp. As always, on Mondays, the FRR Racing Week Ahead post is where you'll find information of the events for the week. The admins, I touched on it a moment ago. So yeah, one of the things we talked about was if the numbers build up enough on those Friday community events to potentially turn that into another league event night, so to speak, then that may be able to be done. But that's also where the additional admins being in place would be able to help, because whether they are able to broadcast it or not would be discussed. But if we were able to put on another event, it'd be brilliant. But to be able to do so, we need people to step up and go, you know what, I'm willing to help out doing the broadcast, I'm willing to help out doing the points, I'm willing to help out doing the pictures, I understand what front row racing is all about, or I want to. We want people to show us what they can do.
But as well, we're not saying if you become an admin you're not able to race. You can pick which one. You could say, I tell you what, I really want to do DTMs, I'll race on Sundays, but then I'll tell you what, on Fridays I'm free, I'll do the live stream and a bit of commentary.
Yeah,
or vice versa.
Exactly. Dave the Art, he's given Breaking Clays a bit of a nudge. Oh, it's Breaking Clays. Oh, and a sympathy spin from Woolhouse.
Yeah, Ken Block would be proud.
I don't know if he'd be proud, but he might be laughing. Oh, my days.
That was amazing. Sympathy. Oh, my ass has gone again.
Well, Kulukutu, he's lovely, this. I tell you what, through Season 5 in the DTMs, he had a lot of bad luck, damaged so many times, it was unreal. We put on a fun event, and yeah, he's gone, he's winning, he's a miles ahead.
He's in a third of the circuit away from the rest.
Yeah, Dave the RP, he's rammed everybody out of the way, he's in second place.
I think he needs to be called James Shunt tonight.
Yuzi, he's showing him what he can do in third. We're breaking Clays behind him in fourth. We're breaking Clays, he's a guy that we've seen on the F1 side of things in front row racing, and breaking Clays has been improving quite nicely on there, and he's said he wants to get involved on the project car side of things as well. And I mean, people can do that. If they race on our F1 side of things, they can race on project cars as well. But one of the things that we did want to try and do with the admin side of things, though, is... Oh, these two, little bit of contact.
Oh, Rick, that was a bit naughty, that. You can save it for the next race.
Yeah, save it for the next race where you can do it even more. With the admin side of things, we do want to, if possible, try and keep the admin side of things more separate. Not separate, but sort of admins for project cars and admins for the F1 side of things. Because then, as you said, James, if you've got four people that can back each other up, there's more cover and it can help each other out. Whereas if you've got, say, I mean, as we know, the two of us have been doing this side of things and doing the F1 side of things, and you soon become very spread thin, don't you?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the one thing for me is... If you've got that extra backup, it is amazing. You can't ask for anything better. We saw in Season 4, I might as well be honest and bit off more than I could chew, and try to run both, and before you know it, one person trying to run both and keep everything on the straight and narrow, but by the time you get eight races in, you've lost what day it is. So yeah, definitely, if you spread it out, it just becomes so much more of an enjoyable experience.
It's a lot like commentary, though, isn't it? People think commentary is really, really easy until they go to do it, and it's like, okay, there's more, especially like on the F1 side of things, it's like, oh, there's a lot more to that than I thought there was. And it's the same when you're running a league. I must admit, though, I can't believe that you bit off more than you can choose, coming from the guy that said he had two Sunday dinners within a couple of hours of each other on the same day one time. So yeah, I think you're more than capable of biting off more than you can chew, because you've proved it.
And it wasn't just any old day, it was Christmas day. So it was two Christmas dinners plus pudding.
Oh, I don't know. Well, Kulukutu, he's going to take his first win here, and well done to him. Okay, James, if you want to get ready to send a message to the drivers, and well done to Kulukutu. Nice little win there. And also you'll need to obviously check, see if anyone's messaged you or got any messages on the community for people to have invites in.
So I'll just set up the next lobby. That's cool.
Okey-doke. And just a reminder that the next race is going to be a rallycross race. This is why James is going to be dropping a message to the drivers, just to let them know. I think if I was going to write that message, it would be, next race is rallycross. What's the next bit you write? No rules, drive where you want. Because that's basically it. It's rallycross. You can drive wherever you want. I'm just wondering, James, if you've got a car in mind as well that you might want to use.
I think I have, but I think we'll try two different ones for both events. But I've got one in mind, but I'm gonna keep my cars close to my chest.
Ooh. Well, I heard you're a bit of a romantic. I don't know, keeping your Valentine's cards close to your chest. Did she spray a bit of perfume on it so it smells like her?
Nah, just chucked it at me.
I'm not surprised, considering for Valentine's Day all you got was a Kinder Bueno.
Yeah, I were in bad books early, you know what it's like.
I wouldn't worry about it. The last time I got anything for Valentine's Day, I was in junior school. How bad is that?
Right, I'm sending you a card next year.
No, don't. I'd rather have no cards than a card off another guy. I've got nothing against people who are in relationships with same sex, and no problem. But it's a little bit like, I mean, I've got friends that go, oh, my mum sent me a lovely Valentine's card. What? Okay, there's nothing too weird about it, but it's Valentine's Day. It's meant to be someone that fancies you sends you the card.
Got to say, I don't think I've ever received one myself, to be fair.
Well, it's the guy's job, isn't it, really, I suppose, nowadays. Yeah. Just a quick reminder, though, to the viewers, James will be, I think he's setting up a new lobby, so I'll jump over to that once he's set that up. And we'll be having a rallycross race where there are no rules, you can drive wherever you want, it'll be the first to the finish. What we'll try and do, James, if we can as well, is put another... Go on.
What I'm going to do is I've just changed. We had the practice before the qualifying. Now I'm going to put the qualifying before the warm-up.
Ooh. Interesting.
That might make a difference. And I'll skip the warm-up.
Well, you skip the practice. Sorry, skip the qualifying session.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, well, I reckon what we do, we skip the qualifying session as we would, but we give them the warm-up session to see if anybody's going to try any new racing lines. But yeah, it's a rallycross event where drivers can drive wherever they want, and if you do want to come and get involved for that race, and then the next normal race, and then the next rallycross race, drop from racing_JS a message. Asking for an invite, as Casey has now joined us, but he's going to have to join us in the other lobby in a moment. But yeah, if you want to get involved, drop us a message or comment on YouTube, and I'll get James to send you an invite. So James, if you could let me know when
it's just creating now. So as soon as it's in, I'll send you an invite. It's been slow as usual.
Yeah. PSN doing its usual wonderful thing.
I've had a lot of on Battlefield messaging me, telling me it is awful this week. So yeah, a lot of issues on PSN.
One thing I liked about Star Wars Battlefront, though, was if your connection was poor on that. For example, there was times where I'd play that while I was uploading a video on YouTube, and it'd actually pop up a message in the top corner saying your internet connection is weak. You may experience interrupted gameplay. And it did. It was interrupted. The downloading or uploading to YouTube affected the gameplay. But at least you got a message about it. And I don't know of many other games that actually give you a written message saying your internet's bad. And I think a lot more games should do that, to be honest.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we had an issue with Stocky a few seasons ago. At first, I think he was pretty adamant that his internet was all right, but it wasn't until we pointed it out to him after a fair few weeks that it actually became a bit of an issue. And like I say, he's been notified, and here we go, Rocket Bunny time.
I was, for a moment, it was showing me an LMP1 car, and I was thinking, Rallycross in LMP1s, you got to be off your head. The Rocket
maybe
Bunny.
Maybe for an
Okay, James, you want to start sending out your invites to everybody? If I do, I'll just get a big blue screen up. So while you're doing that, I'm going to show the Rocket Bunny to everybody. But yeah, we're talking about Stocky and his connection. Yeah, I mean, his connection was probably one of the worst I'd seen for quite some time when he first got involved in front row racing on F1. But yeah, once he... it had been made aware to him of what the problem was. For himself, just getting an Ethernet cable turned his gameplay from unplayable to playable.
Plus, on top of that, we were able to see how absolutely, without swearing, bloody brilliant he was. Absolutely amazing. Whereas, unfortunately, because of his connection, sometimes you'd see flashes of pace, but you weren't able to fully put it all together, because a lot of the time he ended up disconnecting.
Yeah, okay, quick comment. Breaking Clays has asked, is Rallycross on from Game Dirt Rally or Project Cars? We're staying on Project Cars, but basically it's a Rallycross event, which means there are no rules. You can drive wherever you want, you can do whatever you want, you can even crash into people if you like, because there are no rules. It's first to the finish. Okay, so you go where you want. If you want to cut a corner, go for it. Also, James, I just want to let you know that I'm going because Drew has said he's doing a barbecue right now. Come join me, guys. So I'm off. I'd love a barbecued rack of ribs right now. But yeah, and I'm pretty sure that Drew's in America. So if anyone knows how to barbecue food, it's over there. You're going to get some good stuff. But yeah, okay, so rallycross event, yeah, basically, what are the rules? There are no rules. Drive where you want, do what you want, just get to the finish first. We will also do a little test again on the lobby settings, but that won't affect the drivers too much. As for the car, the Toyota GT86 Rocket Bunny GT Edition. Now, I have had a go in this car a few months ago, and it is mental. If I'm right, James, isn't this a drift car?
It is, but it's absolutely brilliant, especially when you're on board and listening to that engine on downshift. It's amazing. I wish it were. It's better than Formula One cars at the moment.
I must admit, I mean, we can talk a little bit about Formula One if you like.
Yeah.
The first race in Australia, you know what? I watched it and I came away with mixed feelings, really. I love how the cars look. I love how quick the cars are. I didn't like how the race went. The race was dull. No. The race was boring. But it's Australia, and that it can happen that way at the first round. It's a difficult track to overtake, but it was a boring race. Hopefully the next races will be better, but for me, that was the only downside, really, that it was a boring race.
And I know that a lot of people say, "Oh, Albert Park, you can't overtake here."
Well, you can.
We've seen races there, yeah, where they've, even when they've been dry, and they've been brilliant. I mean, mm-hmm. I seem to remember when were it? Might have been second season of Kimi Raikkonen. I think it might have been 2013, and it were Raikkonen in a Lotus and Alonso doing a 3-stop and Kimi doing a 2-stop, and everything were kicking off absolutely brilliant. We had Hamilton and the Mercedes battling Alonso side by side, absolutely fantastic wheel to wheel stuff. And I've got to say, I don't usually like to diss this, but you know, it got to the end of the race and I thought, that's probably got to be one of the dullest races I've seen in years.
Yeah, in a long, long time. Admittedly though, I'm hoping the next races, the teams, they know more about their cars and they're willing to push them a little more. But I still have this main problem. I know that they're trying to promote reliability. Formula One isn't about reliability, other than you start the race, you want to get to the end of the race. They shouldn't be making them do a whole season on four engines.
No, definitely not.
In all fairness,
especially for McLaren, because they're going to need four engines for
one race. Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong, I can understand why they do it, but over the last three or four seasons, they've kind of shown that they can do it. They've kind of shown that they can bring reliability in. Okay, now take that away. We don't want reliability in Formula One. We want the fastest car. That means using one engine a race and absolutely hammering it all the way around the track. That's what people want to see.
Exactly. I mean, I don't tune in to watch a bore fest. Plus, I'm tuning in because I want to see drivers on the limit. And unfortunately for me, when I watch the cars so perfectly balanced and so absolutely perfect in every way, the drivers look like they're just sat in a bathtub and they're really comfortable.
Yeah, okay, James, just want to remind you, you need to skip this session.
Yeah, so this is the qualifying session we're skipping?
Yep.
There we go.
And that's where all of the drivers go, oh, what?
So, I think I much prefer it if they were given maybe even more power than they've got, but reduce the size of the wings. Reduce the... I mean, you could probably keep the rear wing the way it is, but that front wing, there's that many elements and that many parts to it. Just, I think, what would be best, and this is just my personal opinion, a lot of people will say, oh, shut up, you don't want all cars looking the same. I would say Ross Brawn, in partnership with the FIA, creates a standard wing for every team, front wing. Any team can develop the rest of the car however they want to do it, but the front wing is exactly the same on everybody else's car. And yeah, it's very similar to a late 90s.
Go on, sorry, go on, Woolass. Go on, Woolass is on the ball. This is Rallycross. He's like, right, I can go over there. I'm going over there. right, come on. And the thing is, so far, quite a few of these drivers, they've just stayed on the track. Woolass, straight away, turn one, cut. Here we go. This is Rallycross. This gang, will it work? We don't know. But he's going to try it anyway.
Everybody's trying it in corners where it's like, you're not going to save time. Just to try and go on the grass.
Yeah.
Oh, look at me. Watch out for the gravel.
The thing is, it's only going to go and get a little bit more interesting now as well, because they can crash into each other as well. That's it. Pit manoeuvre him. yeah. Drifted. See, this is what I want. This is Rallycross. Come on. Let's have it. The thing is, some of these corners, like that corner.
So much quicker to just stay on the circuit.
Well, it could be. The thing is, that corner they've just gone round, if you get it right, there's a service road you can get back onto. But you know what? I think I know what Woolass is going to do here. If he doesn't do it, I'm going to... He's not done it the way I thought I would have done it.
Yeah, you're that gravel trap flooding right down for that path. God, that was perfect.
It's definitely... Oh, Dave the Arm! That's not the way you want to go. Oh, dear. Kulakutu, Kulakutu's gone the wrong way on that bit. Dre's in the pits. I don't know if he meant to be, but he's in the pits. Yeah. Oh, dear. Okay. Oh, Woolhouse, he's got that one a bit wrong. Let's see. Is Casely driving properly? Driving Miss Daisy out there by the looks of things. He's probably wondering what the bloody hell's going on here. But this is Rallycross. This is what it's about. Right, this corner here, do you know what I'd do? You come out of turn one, flat out, and go really wide as fast as you can so you can take this bit really quick. Well, Dave the RP's tried a few different off-track bits. It's not working for him, but I tell you what, I do like the way that his car looks.
Yeah, very nice with the black and yellow. Very nice.
Okay. Now, some people may think that Rallycross...
Oh, we've lost it.
Who's lost it? Dave.
Yeah. I think we're in the slowest corner possible as well.
Well, some people might think that that Rallycross... Oh, go on, Ettel! Go on, Ettel! Oh, no. Oh, it's not Ettel. That was somebody else. Ettel's around the corner. Some people might think that Rallycross is new in front row racing. It isn't. We've done it on Gran Turismo quite a while ago. And it can be great, great fun. it can also be absolute mayhem and carnage. But that's all part of the enjoyment of it.
Something tells me the field might spread a bit.
I don't know what you mean. Breaking clays, he's testing out the different lines here. But this is the thing, James, you were right. It might be quicker to stay on the track, but you don't know until you try. I'm just waiting for one person to realise the best jump at the final chicane. Because where Breaking clays is, I'd go left here, but he's not. He's going straight on instead. Oh no, can he hold it? Can he hold it?
What a save!
He's done
How
well
did
there.
He save that?
You know, this is where he goes and spins it now on a straight. No, he's managed to keep going.
Yeah. Oh, I can hear some crashes. Hang on. Who's that? Oh, it's breaking clears in the wall on a straight, like you said.
I'm going to see if Dave the Arp. He should know from the olden days.
He's got 8 seconds to get a flip in, let's see.
Oh, no, he's gone over the gravel trap. Okay. Well, bit of fun for us, bit of fun for them. And now we've got a race of it. I'm hoping, James, you did knock the amount of laps down. But this is also, again, it is part of a test for us. Oh, God, if you're still on 7 laps. Well,
plenty more final one chat coming your way.
Yeah. Okay, this is where we want to know, has it put us at the back of the grid?
Yes.
No.
That's what we're talking about.
Not for me.
Maybe not.
See, I could have just reversed just there, but I won't. Okay, so it put you at the back, but it didn't put me at the back, which is a little bit of a shame. Now, Woolhouse, we saw him practicing out the lines. Oh, straight away, he's like, Casely, have some of this, my friend.
He's like,
oh, Casely, oh, he's rolled him. He's ruined it. Was that Ethel?
Kalukutu rolled in turn one, he's out.
I think his car's dead.
Well, with Casely. Well, Casely's just managed to get it going, but Kalukutu, I'm feeling sorry for the poor lad.
Well, I hope he's all right. Have him gone upside down. I must admit, if it was me, I'd have probably turned the damage off myself. We'll do that for the next Rallycross race.
Casely's giving him some more pain.
He's not at him again, has he?
Yeah, he's just at him again.
Maybe he's trying to help him get going. Okay. Oh, Dave, the arms off. Breaking Glaze, he's off. Woolhouse, he's leading the race. You can tell which drivers know how to race off the track if they're leading a race they've never led before. This Woolhouse has just, he's cut the airpin, but it's so slow to do it.
Yeah, it's so bad. Just doing
it. Oh,
we
got a double drift, and they're both going to end up in the gravel, Arlie. No, oh, Dave Pitt manoeuvres him. That's both of them deep into the gravel. And who's that? Dre trying to, he's so slow. And he's split. Oh, that didn't work.
Casely spent five minutes in turn one. He's still catching him.
Woolhouse has lost the lead, but something tells me he's going to do everything physically possible to get it back.
So here we go. Ayetel is the first one that will be doing the jump. That lovely black and white livery.
This is where, if I was Woolhouse, I'd go left here and do a big ass jump all over the chicane. Ooh! Can he hold it?
Can he hold it? He's going to the pit lane.
Well, Woolhouse is back into the lead, and Ayetel's thinking, what on earth just happened there? Breaking Clays, that's Dave the Arm through the chicane. He's gone a bit more towards the left. And we got Dre. Is that Casely behind him? It is. Oh, Dre's going to the left for the big jump. Oh, and it's not a big jump. And here comes Casely as Dre's losing it on the grass.
Yeah, Casely's got the perfect line through there.
Somehow Ettel's back into the lead. We've missed it and Woolhouse is into second.
Kalukutu's just got himself going with three wheels on his wagon.
How's he even driving that thing? Maybe the boot was slowing him down. Somebody put him out of his misery and take the other wheel off.
He seems to be quicker than everybody else.
Oh, Casely! Casely and Dre, they're off into the barrier as Breaking Clays and Dave the Art, they're fighting it out again. Oh, and guess who they're catching?
I really think we need to audition for Robot Wars.
Well, the thing is, I mean, I said to you, James, we should do a demolition derby as well, and you were like, oh, I don't know about that. It would be brilliant fun, but finding somewhere... The difficulty is, you'd have someone going, no, you're not getting me. I'm going to go and hide over on this other side of the circuit.
He's got some right pace with that three-wheeled car.
Well, Ettel, I think he's decided, you know what, I'm going to stay on the track. It might work for me. And you're right, Kalukutu, where's he got this booster speed from?
It's that traction.
Well, it's working for him. It's working.
Yeah, I wouldn't even pit. I'd just stay out.
Oh, I've got a feeling Dre's going to go for revenge. No, if he did, Casely hit the brake so that it'd miss him. It's not Kalukutu, it's Dre that went for the shortcut. It didn't work. And Casely drives off into the distance. This is going to be a long six more laps of this race as Dave the Arp approaches the chicane.
Somebody's off. Is that Casely? He's just completely lost it in the Schumacher S.
It is. He's so far off, the tyre barrier's covering him.
Kalukutu's taking my advice, he's staying out.
What's that song? Three wheels on my wagon, something like that? Oh, Wallace! Big spin down at turn one, and Kalakutu says, I don't need four wheels, I'm overtaking you anyway.
And, once again, Ayetel just keeping it on the tarmac, and he's running away with it.
Well, the next race we'll do is going to be a normal race at, I think, Silverstone Grand Prix circuit. Wallace, all struggling a bit now. He's got some damage on, but for the next Rallycross race, we'll turn the damage off, I reckon, because then it gives the drivers full freedom of absolute maximum carnage. And talking about maximum carnage, I've got a feeling Dave the Harp is going to, if he can get into position, he's going to cause some carnage to Wallace, because in this kind of race, if you see someone that's struggling a little bit, you help them out.
Exactly, you're just doing them a favour.
Interestingly, Woolhouse has opted not to go for the hairpin now, and Dave Harp has decided not to go for it either.
Yeah, just to let everybody know, Ayetel, the race leader, is the only one who's actually set a technical lap. Nobody else has put a time on the board. Oh, we got two cars side by side. Dave the Harp. Is that? Yeah, it's
was
Dave
that
the Harp. No,
it is.
Was it?
Yeah, the car that's got sparks flying out of the back. That's Kalakutu.
Maybe that would make Formula One more interesting. Just remove one of the rear tyres.
It could do. Okay, so as these guys are still kind of pounding round a little bit, Kalakutu is so much. He's going to overtake Wallace. He's only got three. No, he's gone for it. Go on, this isn't going to end well. Oh, it slowed him down. That's a shame. Oh, there's Dave the Harp flying through the chicane. And there's Wallace. Oh, and there's Dave the Harp. Where did Dave goes through the chicane at 200 mile an hour. The camera pans round. He's facing the wrong way. Oh, excuse me. Oh, dear.
Definitely, Kalakutu is coming back into this. He's giving...
he's just rammed Wallace into the wall. Oh, I like it. He's giving some payback here. He might even get himself back on the wall. He couldn't do it. Oh, dear. He's got so much damage on his car. He tried to ram him, but his car turned left. But, yeah, Kalakutu, he may be able to completely unlap himself here.
Yeah, he's only got Casely, who's not that far in front of him if he wants to unlap himself. He's really, well, he gets a 10 from me for effort.
He gets a 3 for me. Oh, Ettel, he's got into the gravel, but on the outside of the track, not on the inside. That's not going to be quicker.
Dave Harp has just got in front of Woolhouse, but I don't think that will last long as
Woolhouse
is taking a different line.
Oh, that was so close.
Yeah, here we go down to the airpin now. Woolhouse has overcooked that into the kitty litter.
He's too far back now, but that won't stop him trying, I'm sure. Dave's decided I'll get... Oh, Wallace! Wallace! Big slide! It was impressive.
And the thing Wallace's got to be aware of is braking plates is coming after him.
He is. And I'm sure braking plates won't be afraid of giving him a nudge either.
Yeah, I think he'll be giving him a nudge any minute, because Wallace's just fannying about down at the airpin.
Well, we'll see what happens there. We'll see what... Excuse me. Oh, I've been laughing too much. Dave the Harp trying a few more shortcuts. It's not been working for him so far. Ettel! He must have gone for
spins.
The chicane!
Wallace! Wallace and braking clear both just spun. Wallace is going the wrong way.
If you're going to take him out, do it properly. If you do it like that, he's got another chance now, though, on somebody else. You're going to become a victim. No, you're not. You will soon, though.
Yeah, well, that were an utter fail there.
Yep.
Here we go.
No, he can't quite do it. He's going to spin it. He's spun it. Oh, dear. Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear.
Yeah,
Well, it's different, isn't it, James? It's different.
Well, braking clay is taking a right bit of speed through the final chicane. Just managed to keep control of it as well, so here comes Dre.
Not anymore! Because he's just spun it!
Dre's on his wheel.
Oh dear. I think Dre's going to get him.
It's going to kick off down at turn one, I think.
Oh dear. Well, Rallycross, it's definitely different. That backfired.
And there's the 100 metre marker board gone.
Yep. And that's where now, if I was Dre, I'd do a nice little pit manoeuvre. He tried. Now, obviously, we don't condone this type of racing in normal racing, but that's why this is a rallycross race where anything goes. And unfortunately for Dre, the way he's going is not very quick as Breaking Clay sneaks around the outside. Oh, yes, Dave the Arp, he's in the gravel again.
And Nietzsche. Just he's on a country drive, he's on a Sunday drive.
Yep.
Breaking Clay's in.
Was he saying hello to one of the marshals there?
I think he was. I think he may know him.
It will do after the race. He's come and collect the front end of your car. It's still over here.
Kalu Kutu still bombing round with three wheels on his wagon. He's trying. We're going to make the jump. Here we go. That was, I think with three wheels, he can't get enough power to properly get that airborne.
But three wheels on your wagon and doing what he's doing, I mean, he's gained a place. Yeah, he's overtaken Caseley.
The main thing is, he's beating a world champion. He's beating Caseley.
And he's only got three wheels.
Exactly. This is something you can take to next season and go, you know what, I'm better than Caseley.
Yeah. I don't need all my wheels on my car. I'm better than you. Well, Woolhouse, he's definitely been entertaining throughout this, and he's still going as he loses control of his car.
We've got Breaking Clays and... Breaking Clays and Dre going for the final chicane.
Oh, Breaking Clay, is he going to lose it? He's going to lose it. Go on, no! He's been taken out. That's a 10 out of 10. And I think that was Caseley giving him a good nudge there.
Day in the app, having a nice drift through turn one. Lovely bit of car control there.
Breaking Clay's though, he's in for getting some revenge. He was just giving him a little nudge and around he goes. That's a lovely little pit manoeuvre.
I think we've got the race leader under attack from one of the bat markers.
No, he's not!
Fail.
I think that may have been Woolhouse, and you know he would have been lining him up for a bit of
a spin.
He's
got another one. He's got three wheels on his wagon right up, coming up behind him.
Now, it goes some way when the car with only three wheels is giving you a speed boost. Oh, dear.
Oh, amazing.
Oh.
Imagine if this were LMP1.
You know what? That was a move for position as well. Kalakutu's up to fifth. I don't know if he's going to keep control of his car, though, especially with Woolhouse behind him. Get ready, folks. Kulakutu, he's going for the jump. Can he make the jump? Woolhouse is ahead of him. How has that happened?
Woolhouse is spinning around.
And Ettel...
So is Caseley.
Ettel starts the final lap of the race.
Thank God.
Yeah. Dave the Arp, he's in second and he's still testing out those different lines. Breaking Clays though, he's in the barrier. Where's fourth place? Here comes Dre. Dre can see him. Dre can hit him. Go on, Dre.
Yeah,
come on, Dre.
Can.
Oh, Breaking Clays. I'm coming over here. You're not coming anywhere near me. But look how slow it's made him go. Oh, Dre's going to have him. But where's Ettel? Ettel. He's miles ahead, I think. Anyway, Dave the Harp, big spin. Tried to jump, didn't quite work. Breaking Clays, you're about to get mugged by Dre if he can do it. Let's have a look from Dre's view.
Breaking Clays is... Oh, he's going very, very fast over the gravel.
Oh, Dre's spinning. Dre's gone. and dave the ops into the pits, and Ettel spun it. Ooh, that was close. Case Lay nearly taught Ettel a lesson there. Oh, Ettel's losing it again.
Yeah, I think he might have so much damage now that Dave the Arp may be able to catch him, even though he's just coming through turn two.
I don't know, because Dave the Arp has got Wallace near him. No, he hasn't, because Wallace has spun.
Yeah, Ettel definitely got damage on his car. Oh, Caseless!
And there's nothing wrong with doing that in this type of race. That's what Rallycross is all about. So yeah, you might be leading the race and he might be a lap down, but it doesn't mean he's not going to slam the brakes on us. Dave the Arp sideways. Ooh, thought he was going to roll it then.
Breaking clear.
He's just
going to
spin it slowly. Ooh.
Under pressure from Dre again. Dre's closing in quick.
Well, Dave the Arp's under pressure from Wallace, but every time Wallace gets close to someone, he spins.
Ooh, Kessler is in a spin at the final couple of corners. Trying to take out the race leader who's about to win. You wouldn't have thought so.
Well,
he
might not make it, yeah, because that's Kalukutu, the fastest car on the track. Look at
And that's the race over.
You know what, Kalukutu, driver of the Rallycross event. That was brilliant. That was brilliant. I have no idea who's in what position, but it doesn't really matter.
Well, I can tell you. Ettel wins. Kalukutu was second.
Kalukutu, he can't have been second.
I think this screen's a bit screwed up.
He must have been a lap down on him.
I will set up for the Silverstone Mini Grand Prix.
Yeah. Now, we will have to obviously let the drivers know that the next race is not a Rallycross race. It's back to normality for for one race. Back to normality for a moment.
Somehow I don't think they'll listen that it's back to normality.
Quite possibly. Oh, it's Dave the Arp. Big crash. Is he going to lose a place before he gets to the line? Yes, he is. I think Breaking Clay's just stole second place. He did, just before the finish. Wow. Well, definitely different. Definitely good fun. What I would probably say, James, is Silverstone. It is quite a long track, so you might want to knock the laps down. Obviously, you pick whatever car you want for the supposedly normal race, and we'll test again the. I'm thinking if you put a practice session on, qualifying session, and then the race, and we'll test again doing the practice session and then skipping qualifying. But that was great fun. I got jaw ache from giggling like a
I've got chest
hyena.
Ache.
Oh dear. Well, I wouldn't be surprised if a few of these guys have got wrist ache from their steering wheels going mental in their arms.
Yeah, I think what Caseley did down to turn one I was sat there for ages.
Unfortunately, I didn't have a good view of it. I saw where he was going, I saw that he hit someone, but unfortunately I couldn't see the aftermath or the accident happen. But I know that Kalukutu looked like he went for a little bit of a roll. Oh dear. Oh. Oh, excuse me. I will apologise if my voice starts going a little bit. It's not my first commentary session of the day. I've been doing a lot of talking today. So, anyway, we'll get the next lobby set up for what should be another normal race. So, back to racing properly, please, if you can, guys. And then we'll allow you to go mental again just after that. Obviously, I have no idea what car James is going to pick. But, James, can you let me know when you've sent me an invite and I will come and join you?
One's just been sent now.
Okie doke, I shall come and join you then. And while you're sending out invites to the drivers, we can also always we could perhaps return a little bit to F1 chat, but I will just mention, if anyone's watching this and does want to just come and get involved for a couple of races, comment on YouTube or drop FrontRowRacing_JS. You can see it on the screen. Drop him a message on PSN, or check out the Front Row Racing Project Cars community on PlayStation Network. You can always pop a message on there, so I'll remind James as well in a moment to check those. I was just thinking though, James, at the start of that you said, oh, I reckon we're going to have plenty of time for some F1 talk here. None at all. But yeah, I mean, that was interesting. So just to recap, for anyone that sort of joins now, wondering what the bloody hell is going on, basically we're on Project Cars. We need to test a couple of things with lobby settings, so while we're doing that, we're giving guys the opportunity to come and have a race while we check out these things, but also doing a rallycross event, which is what has just happened, where there are no rules, so you can do whatever you like, go wherever you like, as much as you like, just like Woolhouse did there. Just have a bit of fun. But the next race that's coming up is going to be a normal race, so it looks like the guys are going to have four laps in the aerial atom. Beast of a car that is. It's been a long time since I've actually driven on Project Cars, but that is a car I used to love driving around. I really did enjoy that one. Next race will be a normal race, and then we'll do another rallycross race after that.
Right. So as we
Don't send them just yet. Let's just give ourselves a moment, because I need to get my breath back. And we'll give anyone that wants
get
to join
the
me, yeah, give the drivers the opportunity to grab themselves a drink or whatever, and obviously see if anybody else is interested in coming and joining. Obviously, at this point, I can't send out any invites, but for anyone that's watching or wanting an invite, just drop James from RALLYCROSS_JS a message. We talked a little while ago about Season 6 on Project Cars, which will be getting going again fairly soon. Have you sent an invite to Ethel?
Yeah, one's on its way.
Okay. We talked a little bit a while ago about Season 6, and for Season 6, the best thing I can say at this moment in time is either check out what we were saying earlier on, Or check out the Front Row Racing Facebook page.
Either that, or I've also got the list of tracks which I can give to the drivers. As a lot of the drivers said with last season, as much as they enjoyed the circuits being short, they felt that with the cars being mainly best when they're pushed in high speed corners, unfortunately, with circuits that are so short, there's only maybe a couple of corners where the car is actually on the limit. So we're going to be keeping the settings very, very similar. However, we will be moving to more GP style circuits, so just slightly longer circuits, so that the drivers can really try and push the cars as much as possible.
I'm guessing then that the race lengths will reduce a little bit.
Yes, I believe they will do. I've yet to confirm the length of each race.
Okie doke. Rightio then. I think I'm ready to send the drivers over to the track. Hopefully they know that this is... I'll tell you what, James, before we do send them over to the racetrack, it might be worth turning damage off here if you can. That's not to say to allow them to just go ramming everybody.
Sorry, dear. I've just received a message from your brother. He says... Actually, I don't think he needed me to tell me that he'd sent it to me. I think he'll be a bit mad now. He said, say on the broadcast to Claire, let GP join.
Oh, Claire, let GP join. I'm going to get in so much trouble for this.
Go on.
I've
been a good lad.
Oh, no, he hasn't. No, I tell you what. Claire, you do whatever you want, darling. Shall I tell you why? Because you have to put up with him. Every Wednesday, every Thursday, either driving or commentating, he makes her go upstairs to watch Corrie on a different TV so he doesn't interrupt the commentary.
I say doctors have it tough.
No, wives do. James, if you want to just pop damage to off, and just thinking as well, when it comes to the next race, you shouldn't have to set up another lobby. But anyway, we can send the drivers over to the racetrack when you're ready. And obviously, we are still going to... This is a normal race, and we are still trying to test some lobby settings here. So we'll just want to check whether we can get both myself and James at the back of the grid. Because I thought it was odd how, for that last race, it put you at the back, but it didn't put me at the back with you.
Yeah, a bit odd. I'm thinking maybe it might be worth having just a 5-minute qualifying session just so that people could get a lap in.
Possibly.
That might be the only way around it, I'm thinking.
I mean, it's something that we discussed at the end of the season, wasn't it? If we scrapped the 5-minute warm-up session for the sprint race and had it as a 5-minute qualifying session, then it means that because this is the warm-up session. It'd mean that the drivers have the opportunity to get a lap in, and if they do get a lap in, then they get to qualify. The one of the downsides to it is there may be some tracks where, well, it's going to be a frantic rush, the warm-up stroke qualifying session, for people to get a lap in, and we could still end up further up the grid. But that's something that, again, we may have to have a look at, because one of the things that I was thinking was, like, for example, at the start of the qualifying session, on the timing screen, it shows both me and you being in last place. So technically, when you skip through to the race, we should be in last place. But for whatever reason, in that last event, that wasn't the case. It didn't go that way.
Yeah, it's... seemed to half work, but unfortunately, we really need it to...
fully work.
Work every time, yeah.
Yeah. Yes. I mean, there was something else that I thought of, which I don't know if it'd be something that you'd be interested in doing. And that was, obviously, I mentioned a little while ago about the possibility of doing a rolling start, and you told me that it doesn't allow you to retire until you get to the finish line. But here was a thought that I had, right? Which would be, okay, you could do it where you have a qualifying session, or even you do the random order like we did last season, but you do it with a rolling start imposed by the drivers. So the first lap of the race is not a racing lap, it's a rolling start lap. The problem there would be, though, is it only takes one person to go, screw this, and ruin everything.
And people that are no longer part of the league have we've been in that situation with people like that before, mm-hmm. where all it takes is one person to screw it all up and drive off in a distance. And it's like, as simple as it sounds, it creates more of a headache.
Oh, yes. So one of the reasons why, on the, for example, the F1 side of things, I know some people don't like the fact that sometimes the F1 races have to be restarted at the very start of a race. But the way that the lobbies are set up at the moment in the championship mode, it does allow us to have that freedom to straight away, before the lights go out, to say, this isn't starting yet, we're going to do a new one, with everybody in the correct position doing a proper start, rather than having to do a safety car style restart. Because a self-imposed restart, it's a pain in the backside, especially on F1. I mean, I know Temp Fiat and Eraser 21, when they had their first experience of sort of the behind-the-camera side of dealing with a safety car restart, that was the first time they realised, this is why it takes so long to sort out, because it does take a long time to sort out. While you've got people there going, what's going on, what's happening, why is it taking so long? It's like, you know, if you stop asking questions, it doesn't take as long. But anyway, so what are we doing here, James? We're at Silverstone. We've gone a bit mental in the head, haven't we?
What aerial atoms these?
Aerial atom? Is it a mermaid nuclear bomb?
It's a poor man's Formula One.
They are brilliant cars, these. This is the I believe the souped up version. Obviously, you've got the front wing, the rear wing. These are really, really good cars. The car that's a level down from these, not so good, because it doesn't turn, it doesn't grip. But these are great fun.
Yeah, I'm just watching Dave the Arp. He's been trying to flip his aerial atom over for some reason, but I wouldn't want to do that as... Yo, where's he going? He's going in the pit lane, I think.
No, he's not. He's just testing out a different line. Interesting, though. Look at the nature of that last corner. For the rallycross race, that could be interesting.
I could see people just... cutting straight across towards pit lane entry.
Well, what about maggots and Beckett's?
Yeah, I'm not looking forward to that. Davey Hart thinks I think Davey Hart still thinks it's rallycross. He's going to be severely let down when it comes up with a power boost.
Especially if they're on, yeah. Okay, so there's going to be a qualifying session now, but there's not going to be a qualifying session because once we get in there, James will skip the session to see whether it's going to put himself and myself at the back of the grid. That's what we're trying to achieve. Oh, no.
Oh, it's automatically gone there. I mustn't have put on a practice session. So it put me at the back. Where did it put you?
I'm at the back.
Green, green, green. Oh, that's nice. Well, maybe that's the way to go then. So even if the drivers don't get a lap in, which a lot of them didn't, we end up at the back, which is nice.
Maybe it's a case of...
got somebody trying to take a very awkward line through turn two. It's Dave the Harper, and he's got a power boost.
So Dave the Harper's just realised now that this isn't a rallycross event.
Basically, it's been given a shove by Kalu Kutu, it looked like.
This is where James will realise why I said what I did to him a couple of days ago. We talked a little bit about it. Kalu Kutu, that didn't work. You might realise why I said to James today what I did, which is what? It's just popped a wheelie! That would have hurt.
Nice. Yeah. Good job, damage is off.
Yeah.
Oh, Kalu Kutu, I don't know. I think he thinks that car's got more grip than it has. It's just going into corners way too quick.
Oh, side by side, Casely!
Dave the Arp.
Casely and Brake and Clay's going maggots and Beckett side by side all the way. Little bit of contact, and Brake and Clay's is off. Excuse me. I just want to reiterate at this point as well, this is not the usual standard of FRR Racing Project Cars driving. This is just a fun race. There's no real rules. And obviously the guys have got no setup time or anything like that in these cars. If you're watching this thing, I'm not getting involved in that. Don't worry, this is not the the level of standard, should I say.
Oh, Casely, I think he's under attack, I think.
He's not, he's been overtaken. He's trying to come back, though.
Yeah, Breaking Clay's just mugged him.
And I saw in the background as well, somebody else had a bit of a moment off the track. I couldn't tell who it was. But these two up at the front, having a nice little battle.
Yeah, definitely. A lot of tyre scrub, which tells me a lot of them are on pads, but Casely putting Breaking Clay's off the circuit. Very Schumacher-esque.
This could get tricky. Cars trying to avoid them, and now all of a sudden it goes from a two-car battle for the lead to a six-car battle for the lead.
Ooh, Kaysley has just been nudged off by Dex. And I can hear some crash bang wallops down the road.
Kaysley.
It was Kaysley.
And he came from right dodgy camera angles there, so apologies for that.
Ooh, I think Kulu Kutu in the lead's just showing off a bit as I think Breaking Clay is coming under a bit of pressure along with Dave the Hart.
Oh, that pit lane's not open! I think that was Dave the Hart there. That was a bit of a heart stopping moment for him, I think.
Kaysley's catching Dave up now.
And Dex just went so wide at the old turn one that he was able to pick up a burger off one of the fans. Breaking Clay's, he's caught up to the back of Kulu Kutu. Yeah. Oh no, he's spinning,
Where's his wheels going?
That, I was looking at that, he's got a back boost penalty.
Here we go, Ayrton's through, Kaysley's through, Davey Arp's through.
Well, this is manic. This is frantic.
It's only been two laps gone. Yeah, I don't know. I think it may be a visual glitch with these cars, but a lot of the cars seem to be steering wheels going the opposite way to the way they need to. Or maybe it's just
spinner! Oh, and another Dave spinner. Dave the RP has gone, and behind him, Ethel hit Breaking Clay's, who was the spinner. That was unfortunate. Woolhouse, he's down at the back with Dre at the moment, and some guy sat there, couldn't even be bothered to take his car out of the garage. Disgraceful.
Kaysley is absolutely on the ragged edge, trying to catch Dex for P2 now. Pushing that car beyond what it can do, really. I think the brake discs are lighting red up.
Where are you going?
He's scared Dex off the road there, I think.
I was going to say, these cars are probably special effects engineers' dreams. They come with their own smoke machines, which seem to be working quite well. As proven by Woolhouse.
But if Kulu Kutu carries on the way he is, I think this will be his second win in a night.
Yeah. I don't know, take the pressure off him and all of a sudden he's a beast.
Exactly. But yeah, so as we've got two laps remaining, I may as well run through the track list for Season 6. So here we go. Track one, it'll be 8 rounds, similar to last season, with a sprint race and a feature race. The first round will be at the Barcelona circuit at Catalunya. That'll be round one for season 6 in the DTM class. Round two will be, if I can flick to it, it'll be back to good old Road America. That'll be round two. Round three will be Watkins Glen, so an American doubleheader. Then we jet off to Australia to Bathurst for round four. Now that will be an utter test, as that circuit is very, very long. Then for round five, we're off to the Mazda Raceway at Laguna Seca. So all them MotoGP fans that know of the corkscrew will get a buzz from that circuit.
Oh!
As we're getting Kaysley giving somebody else a buzz.
I think it's Kaysley's waited for him, but Dex has just gone, thank you very much.
So then we're back here to Silverstone Circuit, GP Circuit, for round six, as Kaysley seems to be harassing second place. Round seven will be at the Donington Park National. I think we attended that last season for season five, but it was such a good event. We're going back there. And then for the final round of season six, it will be Brune. That's all the MotoGP circuit, but a very, very fast circuit.
Yeah, I'll recap through those as well while we're setting up for the next rallycross race. But this is a cracky little battle we got here for the lead of the race. Kalukutu, he has been having some right fun, drifting the car everywhere. But onto this last lap now, he's lost the lead to Kay Slay.
Ooh, oh, Dex! Dex.
Oh, crap. Camera angle there. Apologies, folks. Yeah,
Kay Slay, he's finally found his talent and he's back in P1.
Found his talent. Oh, he's gonna love you for that. Kalukutu, though, he hasn't given up on this one. He's got a couple of corners. Now, is he gonna go into rallycross mode? I don't think he will, but it'd be tempting. Turn left just there, it's a lot quicker. Oh, no, is he gonna keep it? He might just.
So there we go, Kay Slay coming over the line. And he wins.
Yep, Dave the Arp somehow, halfway through the race, realised it isn't a rallycross race and comes home in third. Dex, very excited race, finishing in fourth. Ethel won the last one, fifth in this one. Woolhouse, he's managed to get himself up to sixth, and he's had a bit of a spin though in the last couple of corners as he's weaving his little motor down the start finish straight. Oh, he spun it. Big spin. There we go. Okay, so we're going to get the drivers set up now for another rallycross event that will be at this circuit. And trust me, Silverstone's an interesting one for rallycross. But yeah, so we'll get them ready for another rallycross event. And that'll be the last event we do on the live stream, as we'll have tested everything we want to test. I just want to... I was going to say... Oh, you've already left the session. I was going to say, just check whether you did have a warm-up. Well, you can't have had a warm-up session.
No, just a qualifying session. But because we didn't leave the garage... It puts to the back of the grid, which hopefully, if we test it on this one and it does the same, then we're sorted.
I'm just wondering. Put it on no practice, no warm up, just a qualifying session, and we'll skip the qualifying session.
Repeat that.
So set the lobby up with just a qualifying session and the race, but we'll skip the qualifying session.
Then
see if that does put us at the back. Because ideally, what I'd like to do is have it so there's a 5-minute warm up for the guys, and then we can skip a qualifying session. But what we may be able to do is scrap the warm up. Skip the quali, straight into a sprint race.
Indeed, right. The lobby is just setting itself up now, so there'll be an invite on its way.
Okay, James, if you can, once you've sent me an invite, I've just got a message here from Temp Fear saying, bang me. Oh, there is another bit to it. An invite, if anything.
Right.
There's a little naughty of me. Okay. Okay, so we're going to have another rallycross event going on in a moment. As I've said a few times, what are the rules of rallycross? There are no rules. Drive where you want, go where you want, do what you want. It's all legal. You want to crash into somebody? Go for it. There's nothing wrong with that. Obviously, it's not how the... It's not how the FRR Racing Project Cars official seasons are run, but that's not what this evening is about. It's just a bit of fun and just for a bit of laugh and allowing us to test a few things. James, you can let me know when you've sent me an invite, please.
Yeah, it's just been a bit slow at the moment, so it's just resetting up.
No problemo.
Oh, there we go. Right, invite is on the way.
Okie doke. Now, I'm wondering, have you got a car in mind?
I have.
I'm trying to work out if I have any idea what it might be.
Just think what Jeremy Clarkson would go for.
Toyota Hilux.
No.
power.
No, you can't go for that. Not on a rallycross race. No chance. You know what? I would say yes, it would be fun. Unfortunately, I have tried it before in these cars, and it doesn't work.
Once
they get on the grass, you can't move.
Right, I've got a better idea. Here we go. Are you ready?
I know the car you should use.
There Ooh. We go. I think that would be fun.
It could be interesting.
Well, it's time to find out. Let's get the drivers in.
Well, while you do that, I'm going to quickly, if I can, go over again the... sorry, I just got seen. I've got a message. I'm going to go over the tracks that James mentioned earlier that will be used for the DTM Season 6. So, round one will be from the Barcelona Grand Prix circuit. Round two will be from Road America. Round three will be from Watkins Glen GP circuit. Then we've got Bathurst, monster of a track. Laguna Seca for round five. Round six will be Silverstone. Round seven will be Donington National. And round eight will be the Brno circuit. So they're the tracks that will be used in the DTM Season 6. But all future... information regarding Project Cars Season 6 will be hopefully posted on Facebook in the in the next few days. And Ten Fear says, get lost, not these. Right, James, you know what? I have got another car in mind.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember the BMW with the big scoop front wing? The old touring car.
Let's have a look. I think I know the one you mean. Looks like it could shovel snow.
That's the one.
There's either that. Yeah, there's a different BMW. It looks like the Lotus Esprit.
Oh, you're on about the
M3. M1.
M1, yeah. Pro. That might do. That'll do. It's an interesting car.
It's got a bit of downforce on it.
They might need it if they end up airborne. Okay. Just take a quick breather. See if there's anybody else that you would like to invite in. I know Breaking Clay said the last race was his last one. Just going to say Dex isn't with us if he still wants to join. I will quickly mention as well, obviously I've said it a couple of times, this obviously just a fun event for us to test a few things out with the lobby and give the drivers a little bit of mayhem. And say, James, you might want to drop the laps down to, three or four. But yeah, if you do want to get involved in FRR racing on Project Cars in a more sort of realistic, official type league way, then check out the FRR Racing Project Cars community on PlayStation Network. Check out FRR Racing's Facebook page, that's where we do all of our business. So information you will find there, and it's the best place to get in touch with us. But also, Kay Slay hosts community events on Friday nights. So check out that on the community and drop him a message for an invite to get involved in those. By getting involved in those, it puts your name on the radar for potentially reserved places that become available in the DTM League, which will be hosted on Sunday nights.
Right, so we will send the drivers over to the circuit.
Okay, got to try and remember now. So have we got a warm-up session on, James? You to do.
You just said qualifying, but we
that's right.
We're not going to do a qualifying session. We're just going to go straight to race and see what it does.
Yep. So there's a qualifying session, but they're not going to qualify because we're going to skip it to see if it's going to put me and James at the back, which is what we want. So the drivers, they're not going to have any testing in this car, and it's a rallycross event. So for anyone that doesn't know what that is, they may be about to find out. Dave the Harp, oh, you know what, James, I hope your turn penalty's off.
Yeah,
that's all right then. Power boost penalty! Okay. So, James should have the option to skip this session.
Just one second, I've just got to let one of the drivers know that there are no rules, and then I will skip.
Okie doke. Now, I have been asked
GP's
on...
GP's just asked... when is season 6 starting? Now, we believe it's probably going to be next Sunday. If there's any issues, it may fall the Sunday after, but we're wanting to, hopefully, fingers crossed, get it all up and ready to go next Sunday. So if I go to skip to the end of the session,
yep,
we will find out what happens.
And hopefully we'll be at the back of the grid. There's a few empty slots on that grid.
Yeah.
And I'm in second.
No, I'm at the back.
That didn't work then. But it's a rallycross race and away they go. So let's see what carnage we're going to have here then. Casely, he won't want to be first into the first corner because Kulakutu behind him. There we go. Yep, off they go. I was going to say, someone's going to get rammed here, you know it, and they're going to try the full-on line. Yeah, I don't know if the cameras are going to be able to cope with this. And look how slow they've exited the grassed part of the track. Kulakutu, though, has managed to come out in the lead. And Casely is in second with Tempfer behind him. But this
somebody's
is where...
Oh! Somebody's round. Somebody's off in the gravel.
Are they off or are they just going for the rallycross lines? Casely is not worth for him. This is like, watch. It's like, where do I go? I don't know. I'm going to follow you. Oh my God. Hang on a minute.
Who's in second place?
I was going to say, how are you in second?
Pan user as well. This is.
Big crash. Oh, nearly rolled him. Nearly rolled him. Come on then, James. Show us how to do maggots and beckets. Show us how to do maggots and beckets.
Here we go. You ready, everybody?
The camera can't cope.
There's too much gravel in the airbox. It is quicker to stay on the tarmac, I think.
Everyone's just gone flying over and gone... Bleh, bleh, bleh.
Oh. Yeah, the grass really does give your car a bit of a pounding.
It definitely didn't work for Dave the Arp. I can't believe there's an amateur leading this race.
Yeah, it's I've got no mirrors, so you let me know what's coming up behind. I'm pretty sure there was a Formula 1 driver that did that. They said to the engineer to tell them where cars were around them.
I remember Villeneuve at one race saying to his engineer, I can't see the lights, I don't know when the race begins. And his engineer said, when the cars overtake you, you need to go. Casely, big spin. You don't want to be going that way. Kulakutu finds a barrier.
I'm in a barrier as well. Somebody's just gone completely through.
This is mayhem. This is definite mayhem. But that's what rallycross is all about. It's meant to be mayhem.
So yeah, I think Ayetel got an absolutely peach of a run through turn two. I'm back in the commentary box now, just so you know. Woolhouse is trying to grapple with gravel and he's going round. The other way it's going.
Oh, I've gone blind. Oh,
Tempfer's just taken the lead. What a move.
Oh, Ettel, big spin. I've just laughed so much then, I nearly passed out. Bloody hell. Oh, I went dizzy. I went dizzier than you did going through maggots and beckets.
Yeah, it's definitely quicker just staying on
Dave
the tarmac.
Oh, Dave the Harp! that didn't work for him. Oh, bloody hell.
Wow, he's got a death wish.
Well, just a reminder, the drivers are allowed to crash into each other if they want to.
Casely, running in a lowly sixth place. Davey Harp, what's he doing?
Is Casely going to try a line through Maggots and Beckett's? He is, he's gone for the tarmac side.
Wouse has got a lovely run through Maggots and Beckett's, he's up to third now. Kit Tempe has lost it in the lead! And that's Kalu Kutu on for another win.
He's been absolutely storming these races, hasn't he?
Oh, no, he's just spun it. But he's taking the lead back off Temp.
Is he? Because he's wiggling. He's wiggling.
Temp's not going to give up, I don't think, through turn one. Flat out now. No fear about hitting the apex.
Oh, Kalu's gone. He's spun it.
But where's Temp gone?
Woolhouse manages to get through. He's worked himself a nice line through there. Dave the RP's done the same.
Here he goes. He's going really slow. And this is where Casely's making up all his time. I'm trying to use racing commentary.
You really can't. It's so difficult for me here at the moment because the camera's showing the track and cars are going from left to right.
P3. He's sticking to the tarmac. I think he's learning that the tarmac's quicker than grass.
Oh, well, you see, you have to work out where you can go. Obviously, you don't have to, but for those that know, there's massive gains to be had as Tempia. You can tell he's cut corners before.
Kalu Kutu doing the same line. Where's Woolhouse going? Oh, he's taking a bit more grass.
It's not worked. Nicely parked.
What's he going to do? Dave's being very, very cautious through there. And Casely's lost it.
See ya.
Yeah, Bond manoeuvre there, spinning it round. Oh. And Dave the Arp, is that Dave in third place? And Woolhouse now down to fourth. But we know Woolhouse has got a death wish with Dave the Arp tonight.
I think Woolhouse has just got a death wish full stop. Come on, Kalakutu, where are you? There you are. Oh, Dave the RP, he's approaching fast. Oh, Woolhouse is there with him. Or he was. Yeah, I think he's lost it. No, he hasn't. He's still there.
Dave the RP took about 4 seconds out of Kalu Kutu in that corner.
It's not right, is it? Oh, dear.
Kalu Kutu just trying to pray that he keeps heading in the right direction. There he goes.
So seeing this on my screen is just, it's blowing my mind. It's like the cars are just obviously going where they shouldn't, and it is brilliant, but it is making me dizzy. Oh dear. I think Tempia tried a new line at Brooklands, it didn't work.
Dave the Arp's going for a bit of an off-road excursion, nearly hit a barrier. He's pulling up for a fag now.
I was going to say, it looked like he was going to have a look at where he just tried to go. I liked it over there. I'll have another look.
Tempia's ragging this car to pieces as he heads towards Maggots.
That's
and
not
going to
go well. Oh, we just missed the gravel. This could get interesting, though. With Kalu Kutu and Woolhouse. If it's got Woolhouse involved in it, it's going to be interesting.
Oh, so here we go, Woolhouse. He's gaining. What's he gonna do?
Give him a tap. Lots give him curve. A tap.
Going very wide, and Kalu lost out there. But now we're heading down the hangar straight. Is he in the slipstream? But I don't think he'll care.
He won't. Tempia flies through the final chicane to try and take the win.
But Woolhouse, though, this is the key battle going on.
It's not anymore because Kalu Kutu just lost it. Tempia, look at this showboating. He's gonna reverse across the line. Is it gonna work though?
Woolhouse.
Oh, he pushes him across the line.
That was Kaesler pushing him across the line, though. That wasn't even for position.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. That's made me proper dizzy. Oh, that's good fun. That's
well,
good
at
fun.
Least we've worked out what we set to work out. If we run a five-minute quali, even if the drivers don't set a lap time, we should end up at the back of the grid.
It didn't work for me there, though, did it? I was in second place.
Yeah, but we didn't allow the drivers to get out of the garage that time.
True, true. That is true.
So, I was just about to say we've still got battles on circuit, but I don't think my heart can take much more.
Well, I tell you what, though, for a rallycross event, great fun. Great fun.
Yeah.
The fun to watch. Oh, nicely done, Mr. Barrier. I mean, they are absolute mayhem, but that's what it's meant to be. That's what rallycross is all about. It's just for fun. And I wouldn't be surprised. Well, I mean, I know there's people that have said, I would love it if there was a rallycross league. And you know what? As stupid as it might sound, it could be something that could be done. But that's why FRR Racing needs the extra FRR Racing Project Cars admins.
Yeah, exactly. But we have been looking closely at the Project Cars 2 developments, and one of the things that they've put in is gravel circuits and snow circuits. So even though we're having a laugh tonight cutting corners on GP circuits, it very well could be a possibility that we could do a rallycross type of event where it's a bit more of a rally stage, however, it's a race.
Yeah.
So, yeah, the possibilities are endless, but like I say, we really, really do need to attract for young up-and-coming admins who would like to help the league out, give a little bit back, and they'll get a hell of a lot back in return.
Yep. Okay. You know what? I definitely need a break for that. I honestly, genuinely laughed so much, my eyes went blurry. I couldn't see, and I thought I was going to pass out. But there we go. Oh, good fun. Good fun. The rallycross is always good fun. And I tell you what, when we first came up with it a few years ago, I mean, it came out of nothing. It was just like, oh, I can go over here, and it was good fun. And it's like, well, why don't we do a race where you can go wherever you want? And it's always been good fun. It's definitely it's interesting. I like it. But there we go. Okay, so in a few moments, I'm going to. Sorry, I was just reading a message there. It didn't quite make much sense to me. But anyway, I'm going to be bringing this broadcast to an end in a moment, because we've tested a few things that we wanted to. Keep an eye out on Facebook in the coming days for Season 6 information, although we have talked quite a bit about Season 6 already through the broadcast. But it's been interesting. It's been fun. I don't know about you, though, James. I'm knackered.
Yeah, definitely. Early start, and it's woke me up, I can tell you that.
Yeah, trying to read the message from Temp Fear here. Something to do with him driving around with John's tools on his side. But
yeah,
I think
I've got to say, the car with the best livery won there. That is very nice, black and white.
Well, it does look. I've always liked the BMW M1 Pro Car. It's a sexy, for the age of car that it is, it's a sexy looking car, and it's also it's very close to the Bond car.
Yeah, the Esprit. Yeah.
Yeah, that was also a submarine. But anyway, yeah, it's time for me to bring this broadcast to an end. For the drivers, though, if you guys want to keep racing or anything like that, feel free to do so. It's just I need to have a break now. I need to stop. So anyway, time to bring this to an end, as I've mentioned. In a few days' time, we'll have F1 events on YouTube. So come and check it out on Wednesday and Thursday from about 7:25 PM. So James, time for us to say, see you later.
Ta-ra, everybody.
See you in a bit.